Hello all, welcome to my channel. Today's topic for discussion is Malgudi Days. This is a continuation of a video named Part 1, Malgudi Days. Fellow Feeling. This is a wonderful story. The story is about a train journey of two opposite caste people. One belongs to a high Brahmin class and the other represents low caste of society. Both of them meet in Madras Bangalore Express. Trouble between Rajam Iyer, the Brahmin, and the low caste newcomer starts over the matter of seat in the railway compartment. The verbal abusive exchanges between the two castigates each other. Rajam Iyer is greatly incensed at the bully complaint of the newcomer that Brahmins are secretly eating meat and driving prices high. The tension between them mount so much that they both stand up to fight. Rajam Iyer stops short of the first blow and threatens that he will punch on the newcomer's face so hard as to rearrange the bully's face. He would turn the newcomer's mouth under his left ear. As he is about to strike again, the bully sees that the train halts at a station named Jalarpet. He leaps out of the window saying this is his stop. The newcomer alights from the train and again boards the same train but in different compartment. Next story, The Tiger's Claw. This is a story about the talkative man, a recurring character in several short stories. Some hunters bring a dead tiger into town and the talkative man tells a story to the villagers. When he was a fertilizer salesman, he stayed in a tiny village overnight in their train station. He left the door ajar because it was too hot to get a sound sleep. A tiger barged in and woke him up in the middle of the night. He barricaded himself behind a lot of furniture so the tiger could reach him only in one paw. The man used a knife to cut off three toes before the tiger retreated. Back in the town, the villagers asked to show the dead tiger's paw. Sure enough, three toes are found missing. The hunters ascribe the missing claws to a superstitious practice among some tribesmen of cutting tiger's claws and wearing them as talisman for good luck charms. Next story, Ishwaran. Story about a man named Ishwaran who failed his intermediate college exams 9 times in a row. So that's it. After taking exams a 10th time, the much-awaited results are declared. Instead of viewing his course, Ishwaran goes to the cinema. When other boys come into the theater for celebrating their own success, Ishwaran becomes self-loathing and is sure he has failed again. He decides to drown himself in the river. He writes a suicide note and leaves it in his jacket on the shore. He finds his name among the successful candidates with second division. He is so overwhelmed by the success that he turns insane. He imagines himself as a king riding a horse and walks into the watery grave. His body and suicide note are discovered the next day. So that's it. Hope you understood. Thank you.